Welcome back, everybody, here to the Joint of the Masters. It is Na'Vi going up against Team Infuser in our quarterfinal matchup. Because big thanks to AMD also sponsoring the Joint of the Masters this time around. €1,000 worth of prize money. It's a winner takes all scenario. Who gets to be the winner? Who gets to take it all? And who gets to sit there on the back end going, well, I could have been me. I could have been a Joint Dota Master. But really, only one person can be the master. Let's jump ourselves inside the game where we're just having a couple of issues loading in with us. We should be good and ready to go, hopefully, when this is all sorted out. Because I will say hello to my tournament admin sitting on the side right now. He's actually got you got the night off tonight, Ham.
It's like cutting. Holy Master is doing everything. I'm just sitting back in my chair and joining the new game whenever it comes up and clicking the X when people fail to load.
That's what it's all about, man. And there's that failed load which you just had right there. So we will DC ourselves back inside the lobby, but it won't be till before we kick this one off. One thing I want to kind of talk about, because I kind of knew that we weren't going to load in properly just then. RSR's been having some issues. But I kind of want to talk about Na'Vi. Now, Na'Vi are a team that we looked at and we're like, okay, they've been having some issues. They've been having some issues as a team, getting the basics right, working as a full squad. But I don't know if people have realized, but Puppy has stopped casting with me a lot over the past couple of, last week or so. And that's because now you're starting up the boot camp. I think you just told me before too, RSART's the only one that's not at the boot camp right now because he is trying to get his visa completely done and sent off so he can go the international. He's the only one for Na'Vi, which hasn't been confirmed just yet. But I'm hoping today, Ham, we see a new and improved Na'Vi as opposed to what we saw in the last defense match they played.
Yeah, I think that even just a week of playing as a team can really help you sort of find those issues in your play as a team and solve them. So I expect that Na'Vi will be playing better, at the very least, than their last defense game. Whether or not they're on track to be the next international champions is another question. I think there's still some more work to be done, but I think they're definitely going to give a way better showing than they did in the loser bracket of the defense and even the upper bracket of the defense.
Mm-hmm. Looks like we're having ourselves a little bit more issues there's the call that Puppy is not quite sure what we really do in this scenario. We might jump ourselves back. I thought we might have just like quickly jump back into it again. You know what? We're going to give it one last shot, so let's not do that. You know, every single time I 100% think that we should stop the broadcast, stop the recording, and just get back into the game so we can save all those people who watch the YouTube channel of Join Dota's just going, oh my God, when's the game going to start? Oh, I don't really know. Oh, wait, here's a time little mark where everyone can now jump to the VOD. That's right. I can see where you guys start watching the VOD. And when you guys stop watching the VOD, I gotta say, big shout out to all those YouTube guys. If you're watching this VOD right now and you're tuning in for this one moment, love you all, because so many of you guys who watch the VODs, be it on YouTube or be it on the Going3D TV channel, you stay to the end. There's so many people that stay to the very, very end. And for you guys, a big shout out to you. Let's jump ourselves inside the game, man, because we are getting ourselves inside the draft. We had an unusual draft last game by Dera. We saw the Zeus Coddle combination for the botlet, the hard lane dual lane, and it worked beautifully. Don't know if Na'Vi are really going to try something different and unusual against Infused, but I can tell you right now, Infused are going to try something different and unusual against Na'Vi. It's a big, big team to bring down and not an easy one to do. Wagamama, he's got to have his A game if he wants to win this.
Now, Wagamama is always ready to draft against these top-tier teams. I mean, they were really the first team to beat Na'Vi when they were in their stride.
Mm-hmm.
That's going back 4 months ago, but even so, Infused definitely have what it takes. They haven't been super consistent as of late, which is sort of some of the problem that you run into as a team. You win games, you lose games, it's sort of random. Whereas Na'Vi, I feel, has had a little bit more consistency. Sadly for them, it's been consistently off form, but hopefully they can turn that around.
Well, tonight's going to be the night. No, I think really for tonight, it's a big night for them, but tomorrow night's going to be bigger as well. Just remember, guys, the semifinals kick off tomorrow night at 18 CEST. Every single match of the Joint Dota Masters will be broadcast on this live stream. So if you're ever at joindota.com watching it, big shout out to you guys. While you're there, remember to enter in. You might win yourself a carry bag as well as a really cool graphics card by AMD. So just comment in the news article and say why you think it will make your rig more of a beast. or Violet will bring you out of the wood box, which your PC is currently labeled as. So yeah, just put that in the comment. It's that easy. We make our raffles very, very difficult to participate in over at Join Dota. Have an account and make a comment. Difficult. But you can do it, guys. I believe in you because you are Join Dota viewers, which means you're amazing. Let's look at that draft, man. We're taking our sweet ass time here by Waga. Naga banned out by Puppy to start with. And that's because he hates the hero. And we see Latrak as well as Tinker being banned out. Puppy wastes no time whatsoever. No time whatsoever.
He knows exactly what he doesn't like to play against. I see Darkseer banned every game when Na'Vi does not have first pick.
Mm-hmm.
Even some games when they do have first pick, Na'Vi always wanting to take out that Darkseer.
Yeah. Well, he's a pain in the ass, and he always screws around with a team fight and laning, which is exactly what Na'Vi always want to win. So
yeah.
Take out the hero that makes your life a living hell.
He's also a really good turtler, and yeah. Na'Vi wants to be super aggressive, take base towers early in the game, and Darkseer is just one of those heroes that can prevent you from doing that. Just throw up a wall and say, ha, you can't get in.
What you gonna do, man? What you gonna do? Double iron shell with a wall of replicates? You wanna come in? You gonna feast yourself, man. You gotta feast yourself. Lycan's our final ban out here by Puppy. Which means Wagamama. I'm wondering if you'll go down the Invoker role or if Prophet. Do we want to bring him up? Considering we didn't have him in the last game. Will Prophet make his way into this pool? In this hero selection, or will he just be completely ignored at this stage? And Wagamama goes, well, maybe I should just take Chen. Because if I don't, Puppy's going to take him. Puppy will take him in the next set.
Puppy's going to take Chen or Enchantress.
Mm-hmm. All the Enigma's also an option. You've taken out Darkseer. There's a couple of extra counters you can have to him, but Puppy's Enigma doesn't really give a crap about that. But they've got that option, and we will see Wagamama take up the Prophet, which means Puppy... He's got himself his Chen plus one, and maybe they might do something unusual, but I highly doubt it right now.
I feel Na'Vi doesn't need to take a Chen here. They've got two picks that they can use on heroes that they want solid, and then if they don't care which of either Enchantress or Chen they get, they can just leave it. Infused isn't going to take both of them, so then they get the one that's left over for their third pick. Chen.
Well, they're going to take that Chen anyway, man.
They're going to take their Chen. Well, they want Chen over Enchantress is what that tells to me.
I don't think Puppy really likes Enchantress anymore, especially when you're going up against Nature's Prophet. If there's a Chen on the other field, then yeah, you can have Enchantress and you can battle it out for the creeps. But Chen is more of that mid-game power presence.
Yeah.
It was kind of screwed up in our last game when Chen was played, and it didn't work for CLG because AA was screwing with him so much. That AA ulti negating all of the heal just, it really, really hurt hard. And in this scenario, Na'Vi like, well, we've got Rubick, we've got Chen. So we've already got our good mid lane solo if we want to, but we have seen also Rubick play as a support player by Na'Vi. So they're keeping their options very open. You got jungler, and you got a possible mid solo. Wagamama going up for a hero, which Na'Vi hates. I think everybody hates to play against it. Temple or Assassin, and they take the Windrunner. So they're very flexible with their lanes. Windrunner support is something Infuse has done before as well. But it lets them run the side lane. And Na'Vi with their third pickup and final pickup for this first stage is going to be the Broodmother.
Right, Broodmother's a good choice, especially against Templar Assassin, and even to a certain extent Nature's Prophet, because they're not very good at killing Spiderlings. Windrunner's certainly got a little bit more power in terms of the power shot, but this basically forces Infused into picking up something to deal with the Spiderling push, and Na'Vi can certainly ban out the Sand King right now if they choose to.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm actually wondering if we're going to see Broodmother in the middle lane. I'm wondering who's going to be going up against that.
That was Mouse Sports, I think, that ran Brood mid. I don't remember. It happened yesterday. Yeah, they Na'Vi banning at the Tide here. One of the pretty strong counters to Broodmother, as well as a good teamfight controller.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to that's basically going to let Na'Vi do whatever they want in fights. They may actually choose to ban out the Enigma last, let the Sand King through, just so that Infuse don't pick up that big, big disable. But at the same time, they've got a Rubick, so they may not care about an Enigma when they can just turn it around and black hole themselves. 5 seconds remaining. But Infuse definitely here need to pick up something to go up against a Broodmother, either passively and get as much experience as they can, or actively and try and kill off the Spiderlings before they manage to create a big push.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, if you could hear me typing away on the side there, we've just realized Velart's running with no delay whatsoever. So,
yes, I did read that.
Yeah, so Velart. we'll slap him at land later on. Yeah. He'll now be done. I love how Dendi is also multitasking in the JD Special Masters chat. Like, no, don't change it. Don't change it. We're happy, man. How else were we supposed to deward this? But yeah. Velart will get a little bit of an ass kicking from that. 5 seconds remaining. But yeah. So, one last pair to come out. So we had CK and Venno taken out. Swagger really thinking that they're going to run the CK? I suppose the Force has done it many, many times, but it's an option. But CK up against TA, like, you're always looking for that nice, like, crit hit straight as you go in. With a refraction, you need that consistent damage going down. You need someone who can stand their ground long. I suppose that is going to be CK and can deal damage for a long amount of time. Yeah, I suppose that's CK as well. And Phantasm would kind of screw TA's refraction up. Yeah, that actually works great. So take him out. Connell's the final ban out here by Na'Vi. So they're looking at Infuse supports right now. And also probably going to look at their own. I'm just wondering how Wyger wants to run these lanes. Is it going to be just a dual lane to finish up our lineup right now? Do we look for a mid solo plus a support for bot? Not sorry, for top. They are on the die side.
I'm wondering if Infuse here pick up a jungler. I mean, they can also put the Nature's Prophet in the jungle. But I'm thinking of more of a faster, stronger jungler in terms of Enigma. So he's still in the pool. Haven't actually seen Enigma get played in a very long time. He's sort of been ignored along the lines of Prophet.
Mm. Casper's been told. he still hasn't dropped his live stream, though.
Well.
Okay. That's a new one from Infuse. We haven't seen him in a while. Clockwork Goblin comes up for a Team Infuse, fourth pickup. Shadow Demon for Na'Vi, so they get their extra support, which does put Dendi onto that Rubick for, well, what could be a mid lane. It could still be Broodmother. But Clockwork Goblin could be that. They've got three heroes who are capable of offlaning. These lanes are impossible to predict. In this scenario, you're kind of going to know Prophet's going to be inside the jungle. You know he's going to be inside the jungle. But I'm wondering where Clockwork Goblin's going to get his farm. Do they put more onto him on that top lane? Let TA go. The Crystal Maiden support is there. And Juggernaut's the final pickup by Na'Vi. They did not wait at all to pick up that last pickup. And looks like we got a couple of players DCing from Infused.
We are remaking.
Okay. All right, I'll go with that one. Well, why are we remaking?
because we've taken so long to start, Infused have found their fifth.
Oh, fantastic. Fantastic. Well done, Casper. Giddy out. Giddy out. Kick him out of that channel. Remove him. It doesn't really matter, really. We're not broadcasting out.
I was in broadcast channel 2 for the draft.
Fine. I'll switch just because Casper wants to be number 1.
We could both join with Casper.
That'll be nice. Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it. We're both going to broadcast channel number 1. It looks like everybody's now back inside the game. And we should be good and ready to go. Actually, for some reason, my lobby is dead.
You're still typing. I can see you type in it.
Fantastic. I can't see myself type. What the hell?
Oh, My lovey just died too. I can't see anything else.
All right, guys. We're going to have a very, very short break and be back here for possibly part two of the VOD. I got a funny feeling that we're about to have a horrible, horrible trouble with Dota 2. So we shall return here in a couple of moments' time for your joint Dota Masters coverage.